evening everyone. In this session we'll see the next topic, boundary conditions for the electric field. Myself Piyusha Shedgar, ENTC Department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. These are the learning outcomes. At the end of this session, students will be able to derive the boundary condition equations for the different fields at the two media. They will be able to apply the principles of electromagnetics or electrostatics to the solutions of problems relating to the boundary conditions. These are the contents. So, before going to start the boundary conditions, you can recall here what is electric flux density. By considering the different boundaries, you have to solve these boundary conditions for the different quantities, electric field, such as the electric flux density, electric field intensity, etc. So, before that you should know what is electric flux density. Yes, the electric flux density is nothing but charge per unit area, therefore it is denoted with the letter D. Capital D is equal to Q upon 4 pi r square is nothing but the electric flux density. Now, before going to start this all boundary conditions when you are considering the two different media, before that recall some of the definitions which is required to define these boundary conditions. So, here epsilon is nothing but the permittivity. What is the epsilon? It is the measure of a resistance that is encountered when forming an electric field in a medium. In other words, the permittivity is a measure of how an electric field affects and it is affected by a dielectric medium. It is denoted with the letter epsilon. This permittivity is measured in Faraday's per meter. Whereas epsilon r is nothing but the relative permittivity of the material. Next is dielectric constant. This dielectric constant gives the measure of the polarizability of the material relative to free space and is defined as the ratio between the permittivity of the medium to the permittivity of free space. What is electric flux density? So, as we have discussed in previous slide, as it is nothing but the charge per unit area, it has the same unit as that of the dielectric polarization. Now, consider the boundary conditions. So, the problems related to these boundary conditions can be considered with respect to the two different media or the same media. So, we should know the conditions satisfied by these field components at this boundary. So, these are nothing but the boundary conditions. Usually, the field components specified above in terms of the tangential and the normal components of the field vectors. When the field exists in a medium consisting of two different media, the conditions of the field must satisfy are called the boundary conditions. So, for the electrostatic field, the following boundary conditions are important. So, the boundary is the separation between this one of the dielectric medium and another is also the dielectric medium. Other medium is considered as a conductor and the dielectric. That is, the boundary is between this conductor and dielectric medium. And the third may be considered amongst this conductor and the free space. So, let us check the boundary condition stepwise. So, here first define what is the conductor and what is the dielectric. These are the mediums. What is the conductor? In conductor, the valence electrons are present. Valence electrons are nothing but these are called as a free electrons and these are used for the conduction of the current. And the electric field intensity within this conductor is zero. This is the property of the conductor. What is dielectric? In dielectric materials, there are no any free charges are considered and therefore, as there is no any free charges, the conduction current is equal to zero. No conduction current is considered. Boundary conditions can be defined for E bar or either in terms of E bar or in terms of the D, where E is nothing but what? The electric field intensity, and D is the electric flux density. So boundary conditions can be calculated in terms of the two components, tangential components and normal components. So E bar can be find out in terms of the tangential component as well as in normal component, whereas D bar is also can be calculated in terms of tangential and the normal components. So consider these are the field vectors which is crossing this boundary. This is the boundary, xy is the boundary, z is the axis. Here one of the medium is considered as a 1 and the another medium is the medium 2. Medium 1 having mu 1, epsilon 1 and the sigma 1. Okay, so these are nothing but what? The permeability, permittivity and the conductivity is considered for the medium 1. Similarly, the medium 2 which having mu 2, epsilon 2, whereas the sigma 2. And the boundary is the separation between these two mediums. Okay, so when one of the electric field line is passing from this boundary 1 towards this boundary 2, it may gives the angle alpha 2 in medium 2, whereas in medium 1 it makes an angle equal to alpha 1, whereas B1 bar is nothing but one of the field. B1 bar is one of the field for the medium 1, whereas B2 bar is one of the field for medium 2. Let us consider the dielectric interface, that is medium 1 and medium 2 having the dielectric and the dielectric medium. So medium 1 which having epsilon 1, whereas medium 2 having the epsilon 2. Consider this is the rectangle. Okay, the electric field is passing from this medium 1 to medium 2. This is nothing but the boundary between these two. So here we know that E bar dot dl bar is equal to 0. E bar dot dl bar is equal to 0. Apply this to this rectangular path. Rectangular path is A, B, C and D, denoted with this arrow direction. So it can be written separately for each path, that is AB path, BC path, CD path and DA path. So we separate the integration E bar dot dl bar for AB path plus BC plus CD and plus DA path. Okay. So thus you can say that this total path is considered ABCDA. So integration of this closed rectangular path ABCDA E bar dot dl bar is equal to 0. Now if you are considering this figure, this AD and BC are height of this rectangle, consider is vanishingly very small. Therefore these two are cancelled out. So the side BC and DA are very vanishingly very small, and therefore these are equated to 0. So by equating it to 0, only you are getting integration of this closed path ABCDA E bar dot dl bar is equal to integration AB E bar dot dl bar plus integration CD E bar dot dl bar is equal to 0. Now 81, this E bar for the AB path is nothing but the tangential component for the medium 1. So 81, dl bar is the length delta x. dl bar is nothing but this is the length considered for the medium 1 as a delta x. It is in x direction, therefore it is delta x. 81 delta x minus 82 delta x equal to 0. Now this can be equated to 81 delta x equal to 82 delta x. This is the boundary condition for the electric field for the tangential component. But you know that D bar is equal to epsilon naught E bar. This is the equation you are getting in terms of E bar. Now you have to get the equation in terms of D bar by putting the relation between D bar and E bar as D bar equal to epsilon naught E bar. So here DT1 epsilon 1 is equal to DT2 epsilon 2, or it can be written as in terms of the ratio DT1 by epsilon 1 equal to DT2 by epsilon 2. So DT1 by DT2 is nothing but epsilon 1 by epsilon 2. Since in this case you know that epsilon 1 is not equal to the epsilon 2, that is the permittivities for medium 1 and medium 2 are different. So the as these two are different, dt1 is not equal to d2. So dt1 having whatever is the value is not equal to the value for dt2. Thus from this what you can say that the tangential component of this d bar are not continuous across an interface, across an boundary is considered between these two medium. So we'll see the normal components for the boundary condition in next PPT. These are the references for this session. Thank you.